design method, something which covers all the things. And same idea. So when you write the initially the contributions, it will be a page, not a para thesis, no? For a paper, it will be a para. For a thesis, it may be a two or three paras. Then you have to reduce it and make it one line, one and a half lines in the title. Okay? So that is a problem. Okay. So, okay, I have done the title. Then what is the next one I write? So don't blindly say, think and answer.
Conclusion?
No. No, all are wrong.
Papers.
No. Paper is the work you have done. That's why she is saying results and discussion, right? We did in the paper. So you have to go to
problem formulation.
No. No. All are giving Birbal's and answers. Okay. Think and answer. Thesis. Don't blindly apply what I told in paper. The people who are doing, they should talk. At least one or two people will be doing this. No?
Author's publication?
That's okay. That you can do. That doesn't take much time. See, what is the most important in your thesis? See, thesis is not very short, right? It is going to be some minimum 150 pages. So, what is the first thing you should do?
Keyword?
Which one? Keywords. Okay. Keywords, is it? What did you say?
Yes, sir, keywords.
No. When I say title, keyword and all, you can put. That's okay. That goes first. After that, normally we go to results, right? Paper 1, paper 2, paper 3. That's okay. Even before that, you have to do something. Which is not there in the paper case.
Introduction.
No. Introduction is the last. Okay. I don't have time.
Content set.
What is that?
Content.
I didn't understand.
I said set the content first.
What do you mean by contents? Can you elaborate?
Means I will write which chapter I will, chapter number I can do.
No, you got it. That's correct. You are correct. Contents you have to decide first. What does the contents means? So already some chapters we are given, right? So this is the flow, right? You write. But the three papers, right? Which way, which sequence you have to put? And not only that. Contents will contain chapter 1, or chapter 1, leave it, we did. Chapter 4, then chapter, within chapter 4 section, 4.1. And within that section, 4.1. Essentially, the structure of the thesis you have to outline first. Don't start writing the thesis. Outline, actually, the design of the thesis. How you want to organize. So you first write an outline of the contents and you give it to your advisor. He will say this should not come here, that should come here. So you will have discussion and it will undergo 3 or 4 revisions. So then you finalize and then you go and write each chapter wise. Don't go and start writing thesis direct, never. Decide on the structure of the thesis first. Get it cleared by the advisor.
That's helpful, Magnus.
So that is contents. That's very important. So, hello?
Oh, you have.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, contents is the one. Unfortunately,
using it, na?
Hello, please mute. Oh. I don't know why people do this. See, I'm talking about something very important. In a paper, we don't need to do that because this paper is only 5-6 pages. So we already know the way it is done. But in a thesis, every chapter has section, subsection, sub-subsections. How do you organize that? And especially if you have mathematics, how does the theorem come? Where does the proof come? In a problem formulation, do you give it here or give it later? All these questions will come. So think in your mind and do the contents page first. Once you do the contents, the same structure is the same. Paper one, paper two, paper three, then conclusions, then problem formulation. The same idea you can apply. Conclusions, abstract, all that. And if you feel you want to do it in different way, you can do it, no problem. But very important point, the first thing you have to decide before starting writing the thesis, decide on the structure of the thesis. This is also true for a report. Yeah. Suppose you have to do a report after 1 year or something. How the report is organized is very important. See, we don't do all that. So I was saying that the thesis, my estimate for a good thesis writing is 6 months. 6 months. But if you want to cut the time and do it faster and all, still you can do it, try to do it within 3 months. Any thesis writing within 3 months is not good. It will take that much time. I can tell. And don't take the paper and put it. You amplify it. Okay. Any comments? That's all. I will go through the other slides very fast. Any questions? See, I know you are not doing it, so this is new to you. Nobody talks. But the people who are doing third or fourth year, they are about to write the thesis or writing. Before they start writing, they have to do these steps. Okay.
Sir?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, when we are writing the paper, that time itself, can we sort of create a rough draft of the chapter of thesis, because we are anyways writing that paper?
Actually, when you write the paper, you don't create a thesis chapter. You write the thesis chapter and then reduce it to a paper. See, that's what I am telling you. If you want to do the two writing, when you write elaborately as a chapter for the thesis. Then you reduce that because of page length, right? Thesis chapter may be 12 pages, but your paper page length is only 6. So then you decide from the thesis chapter. Good practice, I agree with you. See, that's why I don't call it thesis chapter, you write it as a report. That report can be straight away used in your chapter. You write an internal report first, then you reduce that to a paper. Okay. Any other point? You can save a lot of time later. Yeah. Okay. We'll proceed now. Future work is also important. Others publication. Don't leave it. These are all important. Bibliography, guidelines. See, this is what I said. I show you the structure. Yeah.
Sir, if we will write what we are doing with that, means if I had done something and then I wrote what I've done and a conclusion also. So then also at the end, will it take 6 months or will it, that time will reduce?
See, don't worry about the 6 months. I'm saying a thesis should be a good thesis. See, the examiner should I'll tell you. Examiner should say, I am very happy to read this. It was excellently done. Not other people. Examiner should say.
Okay.
That means it is a good thesis. If you want to do that, then you have to take time. But if you say examiner, thesis is very poorly written. Major work is needed. English is wrong. He will make all. Okay. I didn't say that. But I had to say, the examiner is like a mother-in-law. All the ladies should pardon me. The author is like a daughter-in-law. The examiner's job is to find faults. He will put price later, but his immediate job is to find fault. He will say 100 things wrong in this writing thesis or in a paper also. You should not allow him. You should not give him an opportunity to make a comment saying that this is wrong. That's what I'm telling again and again.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So my good thesis writing, minimum 3 months I need. Within 1 month and all. And if you want to go for a research monograph, 6 months may be too high. 3-4 months, 4 to 5 months you can spend. So that is why somebody said that. Don't wait till when you think you have the 3 papers, you start working on the thesis. Even before the advisor says, he's like a relay race, right? If one fellow is running, he's having a relay, he is transferring to the other fellow. Other fellow is not static. He is already moving. Both are moving and then they interchange. Like that. See, if you have 3 papers, right? Your 3rd paper is waiting, but you have got the 2 papers. So you can write the 2 papers as 2 chapters.
Yes.
Till the thesis advisor. And when you do the literature survey, at the end, you can write the survey part. You don't have to wait. So that is, you are taking parallel action.
Yes.
If you are very disciplined and very systematic in doing all this, yes, you can do it. But still, I will say 3 months minimum. Because you have to read and correct it. I'm going to say again, the same idea, revise, revise, revise. But in a paper, 30, 40 times, thesis we can't do 30, 40 times. Definitely we have to do 3 or 4 times. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So this, on this should be there, right? So this will not be given detail in the paper. Yeah, you see here, limitations of your results, especially when you are talking about results. You say the good things, right? You also point out the weakness of your method. Okay. This all we will not write in that. Yeah. Part of results and implication. Generalization and abstractions. Okay. Recommendation for the future. Okay. You can, I'm not saying systematically, but when you read it, this all should be reflected. Okay, one additional goal. You wanted to prove that to the examiner, right? He's the one clearing it, that you can do good research. And this is what I said. Okay, I'll give you the scenario. Suppose you are explaining your method, new method. So if you want to explain that, earlier developed method, if you give that, it is easier for people to understand what you have done, right? In a paper, you will not do that. You will just cite the earlier paper and leave it. But in a thesis, don't do that. You give that earlier method. But before that, you say, this work was developed by so-and-so, but I'm giving it here so that it'll clearly point out my contributions. And you give the author of that. And whatever is necessary to explain, you explain it here. And then go and develop your method. This is the meaning of tutorial value. That means don't allow the examiners to run around and look at other papers and read and then come to your work to understand your work. This is a very important point. Everything should be in the same report or thesis. Okay. Starting point for next student, self-sufficient, right? Whatever is necessary for the examiner, all the material should be in the same. So a lot of people do that, right? Especially in maths. Some fellow did that theorem. I have gone further and extended. So in order to understand what you have done, I have to go and read the other paper. In a paper, you will cite the paper and leave it. Wave your hand and go, because you don't have page and all. But here you cannot do that. You have to explain what is the other method, who developed it, and based on that, how you have gone further. Any comment? Okay. These are all the standard thing we discussed. Who is the reader, examiner, writing goal? Keep main points in mind. This is the structure. Make an outline. That is the contents page. Okay. So, yep. See, this is what I said, right? You can see here, message 1. So if you see this, this is very nicely done in LaTeX. Section, subsection, subsection. You can arrange it. So it is not enough if you give the title of the chapter. No, you have to go down to the details like this. how the section is done, how subsection is done, how the sub, because if the material is too much, you have to break it. So these are the three papers I said, right? You have to write, and this is the outline, this is the structure. So this is important. So very simple, for a thesis, write the contents first. Get it ratified by advisor after some discussion. Once that is finalized, you go and write each chapter separately and then integrate. After integrating, also read again, because it will stand alone in a chapter, but when integrated, you have to write like this. And very important, when you write a chapter or even in a paper, at the beginning, the two paragraphs, you have to say what you are going to say in the chapter. Very important, mandatory. I'm going to explain the review of this method or something. Based on that, what I'm going to do, all that. Before the reader enters inside, first two paragraphs should tell him what you are going to say in the chapter. Very strict. At the end of the chapter, before you close, you have to say what you have said in the chapter. This is very important and mandatory. Every chapter should contain like that. Beginning, what you are going to say, at the end, what you have said. This is also true in presentation. Presentation, when you start the presentation, you are going to say what you are going to present. And when you are closing the presentation, don't abruptly close. Summarize what you have done in the presentation and then close. Okay. So these are all very quick. We discussed this. Organizing, tell them. Yeah. These are all the same outline. I said that. Compose. We did that for the paper, it's the same. Always use notation, use simple sentences. You can read all that. This is not a claim. How to cite. Yeah, this is important for references, formulas. And again, you have to give all equation numbers, figure number, table number. And you are doing a 20 times revision, keeping track of them is difficult. LaTeX helps. Yeah. Figure also same way. If you put a figure, you should have message. Whatever I said for the blind man crossing the road, right? Same logic and all applies. Then revise. This is the same. The same thing, you can give it and check it. Get someone to read for you also. All that thing you can use. It will take time. You can get the, when you write chapter by chapter, you can check it. And then when you integrate, you can give it once or twice, not too many times. Okay, that's all. Plan on rewriting, I said 3 or 4. There are a number of help files. This is a site, there is a, this was somewhat old, but I'm not sure. But every other tools I have given, there are a lot of tips for writing the thesis. There is another one for getting paper published in journals, like the one I gave. So these are all some support services. Any question before we go to oral and finish it? Any comments on thesis? Thesis writing? Yeah. If it is not, let me go and finish this. Okay. So, sir, you have done a paper, right?
Sir.
And you have submitted to, any questions? No?
Yes, sir. And just when you mention future course of work in a thesis submission, you have to mention future work. So, there may be a very broad area. So, how we have to limit our words to say ki this much can be done?
No, no, you don't worry about that. You just indicate possible outline of further investigation. That's all. You don't have to elaborate that. You are giving the path. Let them go in the path, find out.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
See, suppose you are in a junction. You are indicating there are three branches going this way, that way, that way. But where they go, you don't know that. They can find out. You just leave it at that. That's all I'm saying.
Okay,
sir. If you tell them, okay, I'll tell you, from Delhi, you are taking a road, no, it's going to Agra, but suddenly somewhere you change, it can go to this side or this side to Haryana. You don't know, unless they investigate, they don't know. But you can say, at this junction, there are three branches. One is going right, one is going left. These are possible avenues for exploration. That's it. Leave it. Yeah. Otherwise, you would have done that work, right? But that is not your work. It will be obvious when you do the work, because of time, you would have reduced it, right? But another thing's very important. So you give that, don't give that clearly also, because you yourself can do it, right? Later, after getting a PhD, the future work, you can work, right? And you can get two or three more papers. So you have to be careful. Yeah, yeah. You don't reveal, but indicate, that's it. See, if that fellow is smart, he will do it before you do it. Why unnecessarily reveal your hand? Sir, you said future work, I gave him all, and that fellow has done it. No, just indicate with some possible directions, that's all. Okay, but the examiners will ask also. What further work can be done, they will ask. Yeah. Okay, any other point in writing? Okay, let's do this. That's what I said, Varel. We can finish it within 15 minutes or so. See, you are doing it already, but I want to make it sharp and clear and better. That is the idea. Because we don't practice this, what I am going to say. See, you have written a paper and, in a well-known international conference. Suppose you are in signal processing, ICASP, top conference in signal processing, IEEE signal processing. Your paper is accepted. You have to go and present. What is the first question you will ask? If somebody invites you to present, correct? What is the first question you will ask? You should ask.
What is the theme of
the audience?
No.
Who is the audience?
No, no. First question.
Time. How much time?
How much time? Very good. What is the next question? Second question. You should ask. First question is how much time? 20 minutes. Okay. What is the second question you should ask?
What are the broad areas?
No. That fellow who said the first answer is silent. First audience. Question is time. Second question is audience. If they invite. But conference and all, you don't have to ask about the audience. You know it, right? Yeah, it's irrelevant. If somebody invited you from outside, the first question you should ask is how much time. Second question you have to ask, what he said is correct, but it's not first, it is second. What is the audience? Suppose they invite you to talk to your school children. Can you go and talk about all your technical in that detail? You should know the composition of audience. That's very important. And not only audience, and what are the composition? Is there adults and school children and all like that? You should know. Okay, let's go to the first question. They tell you the time. What do you do after that? Suppose they tell you 20 minutes. First question is time, correct? Some presentation 20 minutes, some presentation 40 minutes, oral exam is normally 45 minutes. And then there are some presentation you are given only 5 minutes. Okay, now you tell me 20 minutes presentation, based on that information, what will you do? See, we don't do all that. That is why our presentations are really bad.
Tell me what the number of slides.
Okay, good point. How many slides will you have?
Around
20 minutes.
10 or 12.
Correct. What is the reason? What is the basis?
So that we can explain each slide for.
That's okay. 10. Why 10? Why not 15? Why not 20?
2 minutes per slide is something.
Correct. Correct. I want to hear that word. Normally, the guideline is 2 minutes per slide. This is on the average, because title slide and all, you don't need 2 minutes. So you can increase it to whatever he said is absolutely correct. 12 slides you can increase. If you go with 15, if you go with 20 slides for a 20 minute presentation, even you are starting, before starting presentation, you are out. You can't finish it. This is very, very important. We don't do that. So first question is time. Based on that, I decide number of slides, and all the material I have should be within the 12 slides. And I already know the slide, right? First slide is title. Second slide is organization of the presentation. And the last slide is what is presented, summary of the presentation. So 3 slides are out. You have only 9 slides to put. All the material you want to convey, you should do within 9. And you have to do it quite early, 1 month ahead of the presentation. Don't do it 1 day before. Many of you don't do present rehearsal at all. Completely wrong. The message for presentation is rehearse, rehearse, rehearse. Do one rehearsal 1 month early, the next 2 and 3 just before 1 or 2 days, and 1 day before. Rehearse with wife, rehearse with your friend. Why with the wife? She can see the message of the presentation. Why with the friend? He can check out all the mathematics and the technical details correct. Why early? Because to get the material into 10 slides is take a lot of time. You can't say my PhD work cannot be done in 10 minutes. You are a waste. There is a 3 minutes PhD competition, not the, what is the PhD problem? Your problem. We do that in interview also. PhD. So that means how many slides you have for a 3 minutes presentation?
One slide.
One slide. You are given only one slide. You had to use that to say what is your problem, PhD problem. That is a training. See, I said abstraction and generalization. Philosophers, they can say it in one word, one sentence, 100 pages. That characteristic you should have. You have done a lot of work, and nobody denies that. What is the essence of that? You remember Mahabharata, Ramayana? All that is very important here. What is the essence? If you are given one slide to tell what is your PhD original contributions, you should use one slide and talk about that. Okay, let me go further. I'll quickly finish presentation, plan your presentation, that's idea, prepare, and present delivery, rehearse. Okay, writing article, these are all we are talking about communicating with others. Other things you can leave. Generally, yeah, more presentation. This is the idea. Speaker want to convey familiar with the topic, right? But audience may want to hear, may not want to hear. But for many person and may not be familiar also. So you have to keep his attention and convey your information. 4 steps, plan, prepare, yeah? And very important, as normally you do, right? If you can explain with a figure, it's better than words. And if you're working in robotics and those areas, show a video, animation, yeah? Rehearse and delivery. So my main message is rehearse, 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 rehearse. Okay, plan your presentation. What is the talk, overview, tutorial? Most likely is a conference talk, right? Technical. We won't do the selling a product and all. And the knowledge audience, he already said, knowledge audience, tailor the talk to the audience. Yeah, that's okay. Major points you want to present, and your presentation should be like this. Why this work was done? Motivation. What are the possible solutions? What finding? All that, I will give you all this, you can check. Sir. And if you're talking about PhD oral exam, one Sir. Important point I want to tell, yeah?
Sorry to interrupt, but the third point is what findings resulted from the work. So if we are presenting us in a conference, so do we need to share our data or only how much data we should share?
No. I'll tell you. Yeah, I'm telling you about the PhD oral exam. Let's discuss that first. PhD oral, you are given 45 minutes or 1 hour. So the first slide is your title, advisor, all that, right? So you will thank the advisor and all, that's okay. Second slide, how you are going to present organization. So very important for any presentation. Second slide is called the organization slide. Organization of the presentation, okay? Third slide, normally you do literature, area survey, literature survey and all, right? Even before that, for PhD oral, you indicate your contributions. In this PhD work, I have developed these three. You remember major contributions, bullets, those three bullets you indicate. That means you let know the examiners what is the contribution of the thesis in the beginning. Otherwise, they will be under suspense. You go on talking about literature survey, formulation, all right, Baba, what you have found? I want to know that right away. So tell him what is the contribution of this thesis. We have developed a protocol design for improving bandwidth in 5G communication systems. That's enough. But you say the details and all, I will cover later. So he knows what is the contribution. He has read it, thesis. But you tell him in the upfront. Don't delay. Then you go this problem formulation, literature survey, all that. So what I'm trying to say is, at the second or third slide, your contribution should be clear to the examiner's panel. Okay. Any other comments here? See, the more you do the rehearsal only, it will come. It will become a habit. Okay, let me do this. State consequences of the work and a plan. Yeah. See, this is organization, I said. Around 20% roughly. Tell them actually what you have done, 70%. And then tell them what you have told them. See, many of you don't do this. Leave it abruptly. I mean, even well-known institutions, when I go to conference presentations and hear, it leaves much to be desired. Okay, this is the overall structure you have to do. Don't forget only the main points here. Tell a story if you can. That all will come with experience only. Okay, this is the details. I'll quickly go through, yeah. You can take a look at all that. When you come to that, you use this. Future work, everything you have to do. This is visual aids, figures and movie, animation, all that I said, right? These are all different things, I leave it. This is the time wise. It comes later, but the first thing is time. General guideline is 2 minutes. Take it. Over a period of time, number of people have done. And if you go for 20 minutes presentation, you go with 20 slides, you are out. I have seen a lot of national conferences. Fellow comes and talks about what is YFDM, what is communication and all. The bell rings. He is not able to talk what he has done. You should know which is important, which is not important. Keep it simple, stupid, I mentioned that, right? So your presentation should be that any stupid fellow can understand. Okay. Visibility, all that thing is okay. Limit the fonts, colors, don't overdo formulas. Don't fill up a slide with the equations. Suppose your thesis, PhD is maths. How do you present a slide? The way you should do it is, the first equation you can give, then you can give the logic using this theorem and that theorem. The intermediate step, you can give one equation and then again explain the logic and give the final result. Three equations only you can give, one beginning, one end, one middle. For details, refer to the paper or thesis. Don't have one slide with all equations. The audience will be lost. One slide, one message. Okay, these are all minor points. You can check it. Beamer. Beamer is the LaTeX version. The great advantage of Beamer is, now you know, right? If you have maths too much, if you do a PowerPoint and insert that, quality is not good and it's a big problem and all. Whereas in LaTeX, if you have the paper, you can convert it to a slide with the Beamer style. Very fast, 1 minute. Okay. These are all okay. Rehearse your talk, always do. Rehearse for yourself early. Rehearse with the audience. Take rehearsal serious. This is the thing we don't do. Three rehearsals you need. One month earlier, because you have to get the material into the number of slides and see when you present whether it covers full. You yourself will find a lot of gaps. Then you work on it and do one day before to your wife. If they can understand the message of the presentation, you have done an excellent job. Because people working in that area can easily follow. Okay, this is the important thing. Okay, I think this is the last slide. Yeah, these are all general other things. Use humor, dress right, attitude. I think I'll leave it. This is all about how you make it, mannerism. Okay, these are all okay. Interact with the audience, questions to audience. Not frequently. Why not frequently? Huh?
Time will get reduced.
I'm not asking you a lot of questions, right? I have to finish it. So don't waste time in too many questions. One or two is okay, because you want to keep the audience interaction. These are all very open to questions. Yeah. I can discuss all this very long, but it's not worth it. These are all general thing. Yeah. I think this is the last slide. Okay. Things, if you want to do a good presentation, three things you have to do. The first thing is, you have to know your subject well, right? Then only you take that material and put it in the slides, correct? So, okay, you see the second part, get your subject into yourself. So you get into subjects and prepare the slides. Once you have prepared the slides, without looking at the slides, you should know what is there. So that means you have got into subjects, subject has got into slides, and the slides has got into you. See, a lot of people put slides and go and read that. That is not on. The slides are there, you put all the points so that you don't miss out any point. Points are not there, a lot of people go and read that. And also when you write a slide should not have full sentences at all. It should be more like telegraphic language. That is why it's called bullet, itemized. So it should be so that it reminds you, so that you don't forget, and then use that point and you talk, articulate. So if you do these two, you know the subject, and the subject, based on that, you have prepared the slides. And once you have done that, you know the slides without looking at it, then you can get the subject into the heart of your audience. They will understand very clearly what you are saying. I guarantee this, you do this practice and you go to a conference and present, you will get the best presenter award for that session. Any well-known conference. If you go to ICASP, they give you a coffee mug with ICASP emblem put together. That is the indication of the best presenter in that particular session. This is the quotation given by Alexander.
There is a time for breaks.
Yeah. Any question?
So there's a time for break, sir, for 5 minutes.
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to break. That's it. Any comments, questions? See, now I want to say that anybody going from IIT Delhi should have undergone this kind of rehearsal. I think the department should insist on that. So you can present to your colleagues in the department, right? So any, see, that's how the NTU does also. If I go to any conference, NASA does that. I worked in NASA. I can't go and present with the NASA name unless I present internally 1 month earlier to my chief, division chief. Then I have to present to the director of the area. Okay. And once they are convinced, then only they will allow you to go and present in a conference. And that means when people from outside come, when they come to NASA presentation, they know it is top class. Okay. I'm not sure whether Delhi does, at least department can do it. Okay. One of the compulsory things for PhD scholar is the seminar course, where you have to present, you have to take a paper, understand, and go and make a presentation. The point is not presentation. Presentation, you can do it, but you have to answer questions on that, on somebody's work which you have not done. That is a training. Okay. Gaurav, you told me to break here, right? Hello?
Sir, yes, sir.
Please yeah, take, yeah. Sir, we will take 3 or 4 minutes break.
Yes,
before sir. That, I want to hear, is there any question? One or two? I'll give you all the slides. I've not done it.
I have a question regarding kind of international conference presentations.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So what I was saying that time, how much data we should share in our slides, or no, we don't need to share any data. We just share the gist of those, whatever the learning
period. Don't crowd with the data. That's what I'm saying. Like, it's mass equations. Okay. You can say you are using benchmark figures, benchmark data, you can give the reference. Don't give the data. But you have generated the data and all, you give a sample. But what is more important is based on the data analysis, the results. Of course, the details of the data is in the paper. You
like
can always refer to the paper. Yeah.
Like the same analysis data, thermogravimetric data, those images we can
see. The main aim of the presentation is what is your contribution. Don't waste time on the data. Based on the data you analyzed, what is the contribution? Main points you have got. But if the data is benchmark data, just give the reference. Or if you have generated the data, give you a brief sample of the data. For details, you give your homepage, website, where everything is available.
Okay, sir. Thanks a lot, sir.
Okay. See, you, what is it based on using that? What is it you have done? Okay. But I agree with you. Sometimes the data collection is a big problem. But you have to summarize that into one slide, not with all numbers. Don't flood the slide with numbers or equations. People cannot understand. Give the logic for that.
Yes.
Okay.
Sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Sir, one question, please.
Okay, go ahead.
How one should get prepared for a Q&A session? What preparation?
Correct. See, very good question. If you see, okay, especially for conferences, I want to tell you, well-known international conference, you go and present your paper. A fellow gets up and asks a question. It means he is working in that area. He knows the subject. That is why he is asking. First answer is, don't bluff to him if you don't know the answer. Don't guess the answer. You will be caught. Correct? So if you don't know the answer, you say answer to him that I have not looked into that. It's a good point. I will look and catch that fellow outside. I want to tell you, most of the work in a conference is done in the coffee table. Catch him and talk to him. You will know he has worked in the area. He said, this will work, this will not work, and he will point out to the other who has done the work. He will save you 6 months of PhD time. well-known conference and very important. I said ICASP, right? If you go to the conference and present, somebody asks a question, he may likely to be your paper reviewer. And you know all the questions, right? Come back and work and submit the paper based on it. That's why I always suggest go to your conference and get your paper criticized. Get all the questions out. Come back and rework, and then based on that you submit to journal. If you know the well-known conference, the fellow who asked the question in the session will be the reviewer. He knows you already. He knows already your work. That's a very great advantage.
But what about the PhD oral presentation? Because your examiner is the expert in that area. So okay. How to get prepared with the Q&A? How to forecast what questions can come?
Very simple, very simple. No, nothing prepared. Whatever work you have done, you should be thorough. And that is not a problem because you have done it, right? And the purpose of the exam is to find whether you have done it or not. So you can answer that. But deliberately, they will ask you wrong questions to test whether you stick to your position. That's why it's a defense. Deliberately, they will ask you saying that your result doesn't indicate that, but they will ask a question whether the result indicates a negative result, opposite. But you have to say, no, I am very sure that this is the result. They want to know how strong you are in your observed facts. The best way is practice. Go through similar sessions. Again, oral presentation, we do three rehearsals. My student undergoes three times, he has to do it. First, to get in within the time. Second is whether the material is okay. Third is question and answer. But as a PhD candidate, you have to be on your own. No spoon feeding, advisor will not interfere. If the advisor tries to answer, the examiners will shut him down. You keep quiet. So don't think advisor will come to your support there. No. You should know it. If you have done it, that's not a problem. You remember I said the seminar course, somebody's paper you read, that is the training. Somebody's paper you read and explain, that's okay. But if somebody asks a question on that paper of which you have not done the work, how to answer that? The only way you can say is, I don't know, but I'll go and read and then find out and let you know later. See, don't try to guess the answer. This is very important for a technical person. If you guess the answer, it may be like this, you will be caught later. That fellow who asked the question in a well-known conference, he has done it, he knows the answer. Keep that in mind. Okay, I tell a joke. See, I'm a professor, right? I'm asked to teach some subjects. I'm not familiar at all. So when I have to read that, right? I have to read and understand and then go and deliver to students. When I tell the students, I told them, right, this is, I'm doing this first time. I am at the same level as you are. So this thing. So if I don't know the answer, see, you can't tell in front of students that I don't know the answer, right? For a teacher, that's not good. So I tell them this code. If you ask a question, I don't know the answer, I will reply saying that is a good question. That means what? When I say that is a good question, you know that I don't know the answer. So don't push me further and sit down. First time I do that, of course, that fellow will come to my room. Then I will go and refer and then explain. That's solved. Second time, first time, I don't know, 100%. Second time, 50% of the questions I can, 50% still not clear. I don't know the answer. The third time, because I'm teaching third time, you know, I know the questions, I know the subject thoroughly. Any question I can answer. So my suggestion for a teacher is, if you want to learn a new subject, volunteer to teach it. Third time, you will become an expert in that. Once, what happened is one student got up and his question was very good. So I said, without knowing, I said, it is a very good question. He immediately sat down. But I know the answer. The question was very good. But this coding and all, you know, this creates problem there. But you see, that is what we do in a conference. When somebody asks a question, you don't answer. The first reaction is, that is a good question. I have not looked into it. We will look into it. Don't try to guess the answer. You will be caught. Yeah. Okay. I think, Gaurav, we can take a break for 3-4 minutes. Is it okay? I want to cover how to handle reviews.
Yes, sir.
I'm not sure whether it will be of interest to you. Some of you, most of you are not doing paper, right? Is it? Anyhow, we'll go through that. I'll go through. Is there anybody who is in the process of paper submission, revision, or all this kind of thing? Can I get a feedback? At least 1 or 2%?
Rajesh just started writing a paper.
Okay. But anybody getting a feedback? First review is over and like that? 1%? Some of you. See, this is a problem. I'm pretty sure there are a lot of people doing that in IIT Delhi Research Scholars. They don't want to listen. This is a problem. That's okay. Let's not worry about who are not there. But at least you be aware. You be aware, you are trained. And when you get the chance, and you don't blame me, I'm going to tell you, when your first paper is submitted, it will be rejected. General statement, not for you. General statement. So how to handle that? That's it. You stop me. Otherwise, I will try to run through quickly. Yeah. Because normally I very much elaborate, but if you are not coming to that stage, this will be useful later. That's what I think. So let me go and do this quickly. So you get an idea. Same thing. See, the same points will come again. I'll give an example of rejection later. What the reviewer is really looking for, we covered that earlier also. Same thing. And then the guidelines for writing the reviewer and rules to be followed. Okay. So finally, I summarize and close. Okay, effective research paper, we have discussed that. So you know that, right? Yeah. What is the outcome? This is also true for thesis. Be aware of that. Thesis, there are more classifications. Paper is this. Accept as it is. It will never happen. You think when you submit the paper, it will be accepted? No way. Always you get rejected. Don't get disheartened. Everybody, that is the normal. Okay, this is the first one. Second one is accept with minor revision. I told you the reviewer editor is like mother-in-law, right? They are not happy. See, they are making all the criticism comments to improve your work. You have to take it that way. If a paper comes back accepted with the minor changes, you have done an excellent job. But normally it doesn't happen. Normally the thing is, paper accepts, they say do a major revision. Reviewer has asked a lot of questions, go and redo and answer all that. And based on that, you submit. We will review again and decide whether to accept or not. Most of the paper get into the thing. The point I'm trying to say now here is, if a paper comes like this, you revise. Then when it goes next time, it should not come back again. It should get accepted. That is where the fellows have failed miserably. They made the paper worse than even the first submission. Okay, this is one. Of course, the last one is completely reject. Straight away, they will give you the love letter. Your paper is rejected because nothing is novel here. Something like that we'll say. Or it does not add value. So essentially that means this is very common. be prepared for it. Don't give up. Of course, you get the comments from the reviewer, right? And based on that, you modify the paper. And if, depending on the comments, you can go to the same level journal or the next level journal. Be prepared for this. Actually, I would say, as a fresh PhD candidate, be prepared for rejection. If you get into this, you have done a very good job, it will not happen. If you normally either this or this. If this, essentially there is still life, but you have to do heart bypass, all that thing you have to do and salvage it. And then next they will continue for some time, something like that. Okay, any comment? You have to face all this, but be prepared for this. This is prepared for the worst. If the best happens, you are happy. But I don't think it will happen, either this or this. Any comments? Okay. That's what I said. Okay, this is the rejection letter. So essentially what I want to convey here, they may say nice things here, but the meaning is opposite. I'll just give an example. You can look at that. We regret to inform you that your manuscript will not be accepted, right? But really the meaning is not really. They're not regretting it to inform. See, another point here. Although the reviews are not entirely negative, right? This is what they say. The real meaning is the reviews were pretty nasty. See, you can read all this. So essentially, they are putting it very politely, but the real message is very, very, very strong and nasty. That is the meaning. So don't carry it away by the review rejection letter. Real meaning is opposite. Yeah, you can read anything, right? We must decline without further review means we don't want to read it again. Okay, you get the idea, right? Yeah, that's fine. So reviewer, this is what I discussed, right? What is he looking for? So when you write a paper, you have to answer this question. That's why I said I put this in paper writing, but this is the same. What is the reviewer looking for when you want to answer the reviewer reply? Okay, all these questions, same thing. Originally, I did this, and then instead of doing after getting the paper reviewed and getting all this, put this checklist before you submit. And if you find any deficiencies, you correct it. Yeah, so that's why I'm not spending time on that. We did this very elaborate last time. Okay. So all these questions, so that is the thing. So he will, when the reviewer puts comments, he will put in any of these areas. He will say the grammar is wrong. He says this contribution is not his own. So don't get into that kind of problem. That's what I'm saying. So general guideline. Now we will see this very quickly. First one, first rule, thank all the reviewers and AE. AE means associate editor. He is the one who is handling the paper review for you. For their comments which improved that paper, your paper. Provide, so you have to answer each one by AE and give your reply. And the reply should be something like this. So very religiously I said for figure, right? You have to put reviewer one. His first comment one. You just repeat his comment here and then give your answer. You should list for every comment of the reviewer one. Similarly, do for reviewer two, reviewer three, and put it together. And then the first para should be like thanking all the reviewers. Very systematically, religiously, you have to do. Here, you have to answer his question very straight. Don't evade and blah, blah, blah. answer to the point exact. If he says, is this correct or not, you have to say yes or no and give reasons. I see a lot of these things. Yeah. Okay. Any comment? Questions? Okay. This is the first. Second, do's and don'ts for replies. If something is not clear, the reviewer saying whatever you are writing is not clear, so rewrite. Yeah. So you answer the question first, and based on that, you rewrite, modify the earlier written version, and also say that based on that, what you have rewritten, do that in italics, and say this is inserted in the revised version in section X. So that means when the reviewer reads it, he gets an answer. He also knows what you have modified, and he also knows where you have modified. He will check one or two times this. After that, he will not check the paper. He will read here. He will be satisfied that whatever you are saying here, you have done it there. Many people don't do that. Again, the point is, don't allow the reviewer to run around to find where you have done the changes. Okay, you can see this. It's very important. Come, run around where you have done the changes. Okay. Second point, be polite and respectful for all reviewers. Even if the review comments are sometimes nonsense. Correct? Not true. I just politely say that. Not true. Don't object. Silently, even if you are right, give the facts why it is not right, reviewer will understand. Very important. Don't rub the reviewer's ego. Whatever you are saying is nonsense. Whatever you are saying is useless. Don't say that. Okay, this is very important. If you made a mistake, accept it and correct it. Accept the blame. If you have made a If you have goofed, if it is a really bigger goof, thank the reviewer pointing out. Especially in a theorem, the proof, some of the steps are wrong, completely wrong. So the reviewer has pointed out, thank him for that and modify. Make the response self-contained. Yeah, this is what I said. Respond to every point raised by the reviewer. This is very important. Actually, you can see this. See, in one sentence, he may ask three questions. You don't answer only one question and leave out the other two. Then use typography to help the reviewer navigate your response. What I mean is, he is asked a question, you answer. But the answer is very big. You can't put the entire thing in the revision. So you have modified or simplified the answer to three lines. So that one you show in italics so that he knows that this is what you have inserted and you will go and check. Begin your response to each comment with a direct answer. This is very important. Suppose he says that do some more work. And you also know that additional work is useless. It doesn't add any knowledge. You know that it is a useless work if the reviewer is asking you to do it. Do it still. If it is minor, right? If it is a major effort, then you have to object. Okay? Yeah. See, these are all you will run into problem. Any questions on this, up to this? The kind of review comments will be along these lines. Any comments? See, that is because you have not seen it. I can see it. If you have seen it, fellows will immediately react. Okay, that's fine. So these are all possible things. Some examples I will give. Okay, this we said. We thank the reviewers. Your reply should go like this. For the detailed comments, we have revised the paper. replies to comments. This is the first starting. Okay, example, first question, right? He has said this comment. Section 2, the numbering of the equation does not correspond to the sequence of the text. So this is his comment and my reply. Very simple answer. We modified the numbering as suggested. That's enough. Don't add too much. Don't put less. Answer to the point. Okay. Second question. Table 1. This is some paper we have written, fuzzy. How to determine the number of rules? Please explain in the revised paper. That's a question, right? I am answering here. So this is the answer, right? This, you can read all the block. Now I'm saying in the revised, the above description is provided. Now you see the bold letter, page 9, second paragraph, page 10, first paragraph, and also giving what I have put here. Okay, I not put here, sorry, the entire thing I have added here. But if you see the other example, abstract is something, right? He is quoting the abstract. Case study belongs to time series. Not some question here. Abstract, we are saying it is time series, but it is not time series. Sorry. The abstract, we are saying it is nonlinear discrete. The case study in the paper belongs to time series. So please modify and make what we are saying is correct, right? This is the answer. Author, see, I'm thanking him for that. Authors appreciate the critical insight from the reviewer. Now you can see this dynamic, realized, nonlinear, as shown in later. However, when it comes to modifying, okay, we are answering that. And this is still the answer. Abstract is modified as given. See, answer is very elaborate. I can't put all the answers in the revised paper, right? That is for him to understand. So based on that, I have summarized the modification into this, and that is why I am showing in the italics. And this is exactly what is inset. Since it is abstract, I am not giving the page and para and all. Abstract comes in the beginning, you can check. Okay. Then another review comments, conclusions. He is giving some comment, right? See, the reviewer's comments, you can't anticipate at all. Okay, so if he really improves the paper, thank him. Comment, conclusion has been written, and this is the revised conclusion. But I want to tell you have to do this religiously. Take every reviewer, take every one of his comments and answer, and also indicate how you modified. No shortcuts here. Okay, this is how we have modified and inserted. Okay, this is a general guideline. We can close now. Another 10-15 minutes, we can close. Okay, use the reviewer comments even if the paper is rejected. Okay, this is what we will all use it. For you is the first baby, right? Yeah. So if it is rejected, you get the comments, right? Check through the reviewer comments and improve your paper based on that, and then send it to the next journal. He is giving his experience. I once had a paper rejected by one journal, improved it with the help of the reviewer comments, submitted to a journal with a higher impact factor, and got it accepted there. So you were rejected. This is again Kalam's quote. No means next opportunity. So you get the comments, right? They have rejected. No, take the comments and improve and submit. I said only the same level and lower level, but there are cases. Then it has got accepted in higher impact journal, because the reviewer comments has made your contribution more clear. So don't get disheartened. Okay, provide an overview, then go to the full set of reviews. This is suppose there are three reviewers. Associate editor will summarize the reviewer comments. Suppose you answer all the reviewers but leave out the associate editor, it's not right. So you have to answer to the AE first, and then you can answer the review, and you can take the reply from the reviewers to the associate editor also. Yeah, you can read this. That's okay. This is another thing. Be polite to the reviewers, but not over polite. What do I mean here? Polite manner. If you totally disagree with that, say if somebody is scolding you like hell, you just smile at him as if nothing happened. Your ego has to be killed, I said, right? Otherwise, you should not be over polite. What is the meaning? You can see it. This is one author replied, thank you very much for your excellent comment. That's fine. Thank you very much again. Why this sentence? You are thanked, right? Once. Why do you want to, you want to show that you really thank him? So essentially, this is the meaning of samchagiri. Don't do samchagiri with the reviewer. Trying to charm the reviewer by being polite rather than addressing what the reviewers. So if you get, the reviewer will get upset. Are Baba, answer to my question rather than be nice to you, me. Yeah. Anyhow, these are all useful for you, because when you try to address, answer the question, that's it. If he really improved your paper, thank him. Just thank him for the comment. That's enough. Thank you very much for it again. Otherwise, I would have been nothing, no personal, nothing. Okay. Don't feel what the reviewer says. Okay, this is another point. So sometimes a reviewer may say wrong things, ask you to do wrong things. So you should not accept it. You have to politely, you have to point out the facts and indicate why that's not correct. This is, you can see. And if you're going on saying again and again, then you can take it to the editor. Ideally, reject a reviewer's comments, but it is outright wrong and you feel strongly that's not correct, you have to stand up for your thing. See, these are all, unless you experience it, you won't know it. So that's why these are all like this. But I tell you, if you develop the habit of handling this in life also, you can do successfully handle people. You can strongly disagree. Anyway, you can read this, I think. What to do? This is another problem. Two reviewers, they ask you to do opposite things. One fellow says introduction is short, expand. Another fellow saying introduction is too long, reduce it. What do you do? You see the answer here. Okay, you can ask the editor. Before that, what I would suggest is, one fellow is saying short, another fellow is long. You know it, right? So best thing is you make it increased wherever you know the best place and reduce it wherever you know the best place. So essentially you satisfy both. But if it can't be done and if it is opposing, then you can go to the editor. Try to solve the problem in your end. This happens also. Okay. All this will happen, and this is what I said. Make sure you address everything. In one sentence, you will have three questions. So you had, suppose one statement, reviewer one, comment one. He has three questions in one line. So you had to write it as 1A, 1B, 1C, and reply to each one. You can't answer only A and leave out B and C. Many of them do that. Sometimes you don't understand what the reviewer is saying. The point is whether he wants you to make a change or he's just making a comment. Yeah. So then what do you do? Best place is to talk to the advisor. So it's just a passing comment, leave it. But if he asked, want you to do something, you have to do the some change in that. Okay. Engage the editor as an educator. This also happens in physics and chemistry, biology and all, right? You are not agreeing with the reviewer totally. And even after the first review, second review, reviewer is going on insisting on the same thing. And you don't agree to that. Yeah. This happens. Each of the bullets here has happened. Then you have to take it to the editor and you put all your facts and other things and let him decide. I think this is the final one. Normally I discuss this very elaborately, but since you are in the beginning stage, you get an inclination of what to expect, and that's it. Try. All the best for your efforts. This is the point I want to highlight. They have done a research on this. The papers which got rejected number of times have undergone multiple rounds, later got accepted, right? Their citation numbers are higher. Whereas the paper which got accepted straight away, the citation numbers are lower. What does it mean? That the rejection and review comments and revision have improved the quality of the paper. A lot of people are using it for further enhancing. It's not a statement. This is the paper you can check. They have done a research in science and look at all the research monographs, the different journals. And what does the submission patterns indicate? The more your paper gets criticized, the better the citation count. People are using it. That is true for science. I mentioned this number of times. Okay, I think this is the last slide. Best way to avoid critical review comments and major modification. You don't want to get into messy affair, right? This is the point I gave you, right? Before you send it to journal, check whether the paper meets the reviewer questions. What the reviewer is looking for, if you can satisfy that, I guarantee your paper will be accepted with minor revision. Still, he will make comments, but those comments will be minor because his job is like mother-in-law. He has to make this not right, this not right, but all those comments are very minor. He says this para is not explained here, it should be better put there. So those are minor, you can take care of that. Okay, looking for slides. I think this is the last one. I think it's getting repeated. Okay, I think I will stop here. Open up for discussion.
Sir, kindly unmute yourself.
Sir, your voice is not audible.
Yeah. Okay. I'm not sure how much it is useful to you now. Because how to handle the reviews, you are all in the beginning stages, but keep aware of that, keep it in the background. And when you submit your paper, before submission, go through this. I want to tell you, before submission, you go through this and try to see whatever you can correct. And when you get the reviewer comments, again, you can check and make your comments and then give the replies like this and then submit. So this is, I want to tell you, the first baby, you know, for a mother is very difficult. So your first paper is a difficult one. Once you have done your first paper accepted, second is okay, third, fourth and all will become routine. So only the initial, and how to handle the reviews also, you have to answer all. Anyhow, you can take these points. And of course, if you have any questions, you can contact me anytime. That's okay. But I said the reviewer's question. This is also true for examiner's question for your thesis. And before that, anyhow, paper will come. You will get experienced. So I think I will stop here. I would really like to discuss with the people who are doing paper submission, getting rejected and all that. But that's okay. They are not here. That's fine. Any questions on today's session? Then we can discuss for some time and close. And tomorrow is the last one. I want to talk about ethics. Very important, you should all know, and some general advice given by a big professor. Okay. Yeah, I will open it up, and I see a lot of people are disappearing. That's okay. Those who want to ask questions, you can remain and we can discuss. We have time, right? We can go up to 7:30. No problem. Time is 7:15, so we have 15 minutes. We can try. Okay. Any comments, questions? Anything on discussion? Not in this topic, on all the topics. I see something in the chat. Let me see. Okay, this is okay. Okay, any comments, questions, or nothing is there? Or even in thesis writing, oral presentation.
Hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
Hello. Sir, I have a question, like for representation of graphs in a paper. Like certain paper put the graphs in a box, like x, y, axis, and it is fully enclosed in a box. Some paper have only like for a square, only two sides are like visible and the two other are like open. So is there any specific thing that one should be representing the graphs in the paper?
It is simple, madam. This,
yes, sir.
So this depends on the journal template. Okay. That is why I'm saying in LaTeX, if you use, they give you the journal template and it is automatically put what the journal wants. You don't worry about all that. You're in which discipline?
So mechanical engineering.
Essentially, which area? Manufacturing?
No, sir, solar energy.
Solar energy. You look at the journals and you look at the template of, see, are you familiar with LaTeX? No.
No, sir.
Okay. Anyhow, you learn the LaTeX and what the journal wants that is given to you, you try to fit in that, that's enough. You don't worry about whether they put border, put this thing, the system, that template will take care of it automatically.
Okay, sir. And there was one more question similar like that. Like one of my work involves a parametric study.
Okay.
So, like for a presentation, I have to discuss how the parameters are varying, like for different results. So in a presentation, it should be like three graphs per slide or something for a better understanding of the audience.
Okay, so my suggestion is don't clutter too much information in one slide. You said three figures in one slide, right? Don't do that.
Okay,
if you
sir.
Can put one figure for each slide, if you can. Otherwise, put at the most two, not three. So the slide should not contain too much information. A lot of people do that. Left side something, right corner something, right bottom something, left bottom, and then in center something, and the fellow cannot follow it because you want to keep within four slides all the information. Never do that. My suggestion is do it. Okay, you want to vary three parameters, show the effect separately. Three parameters, three slides, three figures.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Good evening, Professor.
Yeah.
Professor, I want to ask something.
Okay.
One is like while presenting our research plan, we present suppose three aims, A, B, and C that we will do during our PhD.
Okay.
And in I have communicated two papers till now.
Okay.
So one of the paper is in first revision has been done. Second is in the first reply has to come.
Okay.
So I was asking, shall if I want to think of starting writing thesis, shall I proceed or will it miss the essence of the whole story?
No. My suggestion is that paper is just already accepted. You can write the chapter. See, within the chapter you can write, right? So integrating that into putting and all, that cannot be done now because you had to have three papers, right? Mm-hmm. So you had to wait. But the chapter corresponding to that paper, you can write.
Okay. And while presenting the research plan, suppose we have mentioned we will do A. In the paper, we have given half of A, for example.
No, that is okay, madam. Now, I'm telling you, research plan is not a contract. Mm-hmm. See, because research is always uncertain. You don't know where the destination is. Research is a journey with destination unknown. You won't know where you are going to end up. In the beginning, you would have given a title for the PhD topic, but after investigation, the papers you published and you combine it, the title will be different. So you have to change the title. Committee will be accepting that, except that you have to give the reason. The reason is the current material properly reflects the title. The current title reflects the content of the thesis properly. You can change the title all the time. So the plan is just a plan. Don't think it is a contract.
Thank you. Yeah,
don't worry about that. But you are already submitting a paper and got the review. When I ask the question, you are silent. How was your review questions?
So they were actually quite helpful terms of.
Is it a minor correction or major correction?
Major.
Okay. They want you to do more work.
What they were asking is what I have emphasized on suppose point A, but the uniqueness of my paper was point B. So they asked me to focus on B and write more about that instead of focusing on A.
So definitely it will improve the quality, right? You take in the right spirit.
Yes.
Take it. And after you did the revision, they accepted. Straight away?
No, reply is yet to come.
No, even for the first paper, is it?
No, for first paper, first revision is submitted, that reply has to come.
You are not, the paper is not accepted yet. That's why you are keeping quiet. You are not sure whether.
Yes.
Hopefully you have confidence that it will get accepted. You have. Let me ask you, you have answered all the reviewers questions like the way I indicated?
Professor, what I missed is, like you mentioned, there were multiple. So that thing was there.
Yeah.
And sometimes I was not able to, somehow I missed one or two small part of a sentence. So I'm worried about that. If that will.
No, but you go, my suggestion is, you go back and answer all those left out parts and make your reply complete. If the reviewer comes, you have not answered it, you can say that I have done it, but I forgot to include, then you can send this update.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't wait till they reply. You complete it, whatever was left out and all, but don't complete only that portion, complete the entire reply. But they will still, is it a major point or minor point?
Minor only.
Yeah. But you can still, they will still accept with minor revision. You have to answer that and all. But you can send it. See, that is why, that's why people who get the first reply, they should go through this. That is the reason why that my friend asked me to do this to all the research scholars. Because see, they could have rejected the paper, right? But they feel there is something in the paper worth publishing. That is why the first review comments is given. And when you resubmit after the reply to the review comments, the quality should improve. You see that statement? That fellow revised based on the comments and submitted to a higher impact journal and got accepted. That is the normal progression. But it will happen. You are fresh, right?
Yes.
Next paper you do, you handle like this. You will see you will not miss any point, and you would have answered all the points. And then the review, see, I tell you the psychology of the reviewer. I read the reply. I get everything here, right? Then you also indicated how you have inserted in the revision, right? I will randomly go and check two or three places. If I check you have done it, I won't check the revised paper. I will look at reply. If I am satisfied here, I will say accept. You have to understand the psychology. You make the life easier for the reviewer. Okay.
Professor, one more thing. My professor has also included me into as a reviewer. Also, I am included in the process.
Okay.
I don't know. Sometimes I feel like I should not reject, like as a human.
Don't worry about the reject. You see, I have given the checklist, right, for the reviewer. You see, especially in the top, if there is any major no answer, you have to reject it.
So generally, I give major revision instead of reject.
No, that is okay. But still, the AE will take over and he will tell. But don't be polite here. That's what I'm saying. You give the facts. If you see, that is why it is your feeling, subjective comment. Okay? You answer me this question. Is there something original in the paper?
Yes, but that is not very big, like a very small contribution is there, suppose.
Okay. Then is the paper clearly written?
Yes, well written.
Yeah. Is the plagiarism, they are not done any plagiarism and all, right?
No.
Okay.
No.
You can ask them to do more work and submit.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
You say the contribution is minor, that you have to do more and show to quantify for a full thing. You can put like that. Do major work and submit and review again. The decision of acceptance is delayed after you do them. See, normally everybody gets into the major revision. Yeah. So that part is okay. But there is something, but it is very minor. You don't have to say all. The contribution, some more work has to be done. You put like that. That's a good experience your advisor has done. Normally, we do that to our students also. We give the paper to for that. But the advisor asks you to submit directly or give it to him. He will moderate and submit.
Initially, he used to instruct me that you give your review, I will see. Now I am solely allowed to review.
Yeah, then he thinks you are matured. Yeah. Okay, go ahead and do it. Don't worry about that. Don't be nice and all. You know, that doesn't work here. If you make a good comment, it is to improve the quality of the paper. Yeah. See, that's why I'm saying being nice to the reviewer is not the point. But, so whatever you feel, you say. That's it.
Okay, Professor. Thank you very much.
Okay. Any other point?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, can you suggest some online resources or share some insights on academic book writing?
Academic? What?
Book writing, sir.
Book writing is the same as writing. It should be there. I can suggest, but you yourself can do. Do a Google. How to write a book, academic book. You can put that. See, some of the tools I have given, they are for papers. And there are a good lot of things for thesis writing, how to do good thesis writing. You can put a search, how to do good book writing. You will get some.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, you will get. But see, all these problems can be really kept simpler if you know LaTeX. I talked to Prasad Srinath, he said he will arrange it. learn the LaTeX early. See, you are already submitting paper and all, you know, you should be aware of LaTeX. It will save you a lot of agonies later. Yeah. Okay. Is there any other question? Otherwise,
Sir, I have a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, some of the students want to publish their thesis work as a book. So should they publish a paper from their book? Should they publish their chapters for the journals if they have a plan to publish their thesis as a book afterwards? And my second question is that most of the
Hold on. Can you stop here? Normally I'll tell you, the thesis is done after the papers are published. Is it clear? You publish the three papers, then write the thesis. Correct? Is that correct? Hello?
Sir, but nowadays Indian universities allow that it is not mandatory here that because publication is not mandatory. Students publish, but they publish something else, not their chapters.
No, not the chapters.
Some friends.
I don't know. You are in IIT?
Yes, sir. I am in IIT.
Which department you are in?
Sir, I'm in social sciences.
Okay, I can see that. So, they don't insist on paper publication before your thesis is submitted.
Yes, sir.
Thesis can be in different area and papers can be in different area.
Sir, they allow me to publish something not from the thesis, but something else.
I'll tell you the US system in engineering, papers are not published first. They don't insist on that. Your thesis is done first. Why? Because the committee there, they can certify this original or not. The thesis is first is accepted and submitted, then the chapters of the thesis are converted to papers later. That is the US system. Okay. But in our system, in engineering and science, papers are published because they want original certificate, right? The paper publication is the one. But in your social science, if the committee agrees the thesis is okay, given a PhD, and then you publish papers in a different area, that's fine. But you want to take the chapters and publish it in a paper or in a book, is it? Is that what is the question now?
Sir, my question is if somebody because you already satisfied one query, and the second is that some of the humanities student don't publish their chapters for the journals, but they publish it later in the book. So if somebody has a plan to publish a book for a thesis, that is a very ambitious project or something he or she is working on. So should they publish for the journal, or they should not publish if they have a plan to publish it for a book?
Okay, I will give you the answer from engineering side. The same applies here also. Suppose I publish the papers first in the journal, then I complete that as a thesis, and later I convert the thesis as a research monograph, right? Which is like a book. So I am using the same material which is published in the journal for the book. So this becomes a copyright problem, right? So since the work is your own, you can get permission from the journal and still put that in the book. But the publisher of the book will insist on getting all the clearances from all the earlier published sources. So if you are going to do that as a book, and then you want to take a chapter and publish in the journal, I don't know. So which one comes first? Book comes first or journal comes first? Hello?
Sir, I want to say thesis will come first.
Thesis is okay. After that, you said you want to write a book, right? Or you want to publish the chapter in a journal, right? Which one comes first?
Sir, it depends. I think
doing the same material in two different publications will violate copyright. You can publish, but if you use the same thing in the book, you have to get the clearance from them. If you do that in book, and later you want to take that into I don't know why you want to do, see, if you are doing in a book, why you want to do in a journal? Because you already got the thesis degree, right? PhD. Yeah. So your PhD thesis is a book. Why you want to publish in your journal?
Sir, I had a query because I have seen some of my professors have published or some of my friends have published their PhD work as a book, but they did not publish the same work for the journals. So I had a question in my mind.
You cannot. That's what I'm saying. That
okay,
that
sir.
Is what you have to do. You know, you can't use the same material for a double credit.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Very simple. No, you publish in a conference. Take the same thing and you can't send it to your journal. You have to modify. You can take the book chapter and modify it, improve it further and submit it to your journal.
Okay, sir. Okay.
You can't do the same thing twice. Get credit. Okay. That is why I asked the question. Whether
okay, thank you. Thank you, sir.
I think for you, the book will be more important than a journal, right? Journal paper is a small part, whereas a book is comprehensive.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Okay. I hope I answered because I'm not in the domain, but I know a lot of people. But what they will do is once the thesis is done, you can publish in journal and then collect the material and then put as a book. When you book it, put as a book, you have to get the permission from the journal to use that material in the book. They will give it because it is your own work, right? So they will give.
Sir.
They will give.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
I have learned a lot, sir.
Okay, hopefully. That's yes, the idea.
Sir, I am religiously attending lecture from 5 to till it goes 8:30 or something.
Can I know your name?
Sir, my name is Geeta Mishra.
Okay. You are in sociology, is it? Which area?
Sir, I'm in English literature.
Okay, but I am surprised people in English literature attending this. This is for
because,
engineering
sir,
science.
Yeah, there was something when I attended your first lecture, I found it something different that I have not heard before. And I'm very inquisitive learner. So whenever there are such kind of workshop our library organizes, I always attended it and I have learned a lot. And you know, there are so many points that I have making. I was taking the notes, okay. So I have learned some new things.
No, this is mainly common sense talk and based on the experience, where people don't talk about all this. And I know a lot of students and in engineering PhD they suffer all kind of tension in, especially in the initial first 2 to 3 years. And I have seen a lot of. I have done it over the last 10 years to a number of students. And the benefits is the one I see in the students keep me going on this. But I have seen a lot of people in IIT Madras, also management people attending. I asked this question, why are you attending this, sir? Whatever you're saying is very common sense. I can directly apply in management also. So I'm very happy that, because social science research is a different area. Whatever I am saying, like experiment,
yes,
simulation and all will not be going directly. It's more like opinion, survey, psychology, sociology, all those areas. So that has to be done separately and they will do that. And statistical techniques is very important there. So here also it is important. I don't cover that. I more like soft skills. That's what I am doing. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes.
Thank you very much, madam. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. My pleasure.
You are a faculty, is it?
Yes, sir, I am not a faculty right now, but yeah, I used to teach somewhere before joining the PhD.
So you are finished the PhD or the final stage?
So it is on the final stage.
So you can help a lot of our scholars on English writing and all, you know, they get into a lot of problems.
Sure,
in paper
sir,
writing.
Sure. But yeah. After submitting my thesis.
Yeah, yeah, do that. After that, you can let know the dean research that you are available if somebody wants any help. Yeah.
Okay, sir, I'll think about it. Thank you so much, sir, for a kind comment, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks a lot,
Yeah.
Good night, sir. Thanks a lot for your insightful lecture and kind words.
Yeah, okay, madam. Thank you. You send me an email. That's enough. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sure, I will send you an email.
We can correspond offline. Yeah.
Sure, sir.
Okay. Any other comments? Otherwise, we can close. Gaurav? Yeah, anybody has any other discussion? Tomorrow is very important, ethics. Yeah, I will tell all the things, and it is not for you to educate you on that. It is for you to not to do that kind of thing. Anyhow, we will see that tomorrow. Okay?
Yes, sir.
I think we run into our normal time now. Any questions, anything? Otherwise, we will close. Oh, I think you can close, right?
Right.